Welcome to the session. Topic of this session is mutually exclusive alternatives and entirely different project. We use different techniques to select the best project out of available different alternatives. There are undiscounted techniques, there are discounting techniques, and we also know how to select the best project in the condition when there is a chance of uncertainty. You know, the some parameters of the cost and benefit, there is a chance to vary in the future. So in that condition we use the sensitivity analysis. And there is another conditions where we have the instances of mutually exclusive alternatives or entirely different project, where we can select only one project, only one project design we can select. You know, the resources, the conditions allow to, you know, select only one project or only one project design. So in this session, basically, we are going to discuss how to take decision, how to select the best options if there is a instances of mutually exclusive alternatives are there. And also at the end of this session, basically, we will be also discussing some of the issues in the project analysis, such as the domestic resource cost and the contingency allowances, the salvage values, and all such issues we will be also discussing in this session. Basically, sometimes they face the problem of having to choose among the mutually exclusive alternatives. You know, they have to select the only one project design options, or, you know, they have to select only one whole project. If, you know, in such cases or in mutually exclusive alternative options, if one option is chosen, the other cannot be undertaken. So, you know, like the examples are the development of the surface irrigation or not tube well irrigation, we can say, or, you know, river development upstream rather than the downstreams, or, you know, the plants in alternative locations, but, you know, this the plants serving the same limited market, so there is no need to go for different location because there is a limited market is available, so only one location is sufficient to have the planting. We have to select only one options, you know, there is no other way to go for second project or second option. So such type of situation arises before the analyst. So how to take? So, you know, there are some issues are there, like project design issues, where we have to go for only one options, like in case of scales of project, you know. I know when we adopt one size of project precludes the implementing a similar project of another size. So either we select the small size project or big size project, but there is an option of selecting one size. You know, like in time phasing also, you know, we have this, you know, project, you know, same project we have, but, you know, that can be taken, but they have different design for project components, you know, different phases we have to go. So that is that, like our third option or third expenses of mutually exclusive arises before us. Project have multi-purpose project, and one project may have one additional purpose of, you know, implementing that project. So such situation arises before the analyst. So actually, here the analyst need to compare mutually exclusive design options. This is the, you know, one of the principal reason to undertake economic analysis early in the project cycle. You know, if such situation arises, then we need to undertake this economic analysis of the project, which is in the earliest possible in the project cycle. So, and how to take the decision and on which project the measuring technique should be adopted. So the most preferred discounted measures of project worth, that is the, you know, the net present worth, can be used, you know, should be used to take the decisions about the which option or which project is best in the mutually exclusive conditions, you know. And here, you know, direct comparison of the internal rate of return, the benefit cost ratio or the net benefit investment ratio can lead to an incorrect investment decisions, because you know the small size but high paying project may preclude the generating more wealth through a moderately remunerative but larger alternative. Because in case of the, you know, benefit cost ratio or the internal rate of return, they provide the comparison of benefit and cost, or you know, they provide the rate of return. So if a small project which is having high return, rate of return is high, or which generate more benefit, but total amount, you know, the money generated by that project is less, so in that condition, you know, that will not give a proper decision. So that's why the net present worth can be used to have a, you know, best techniques or discounted measures to measure the project worth or to take the decisions. So, you know, sometimes, you know, a pair of project at first look like mutually exclusive project, you know. Sometimes what happens, you know, there are two projects are there and they looks like, you know, they are the alternative to each other, and out of that one can be selected. But sometimes what we found, they are basically, you know, a successive phases of development. First we start developing the small project and then we can go for the larger project. So, you know, the small project can be expanded by phases to become a larger alternative. And in such cases, there is no analytical problems we found. And to implement a small, or the, we can say the first phase project does not preempt a larger secondary project. So, you know, if you implement in such a case the small project, it will not preclude the larger project. So both phases can be undertaken, with each phase judged by any one of the measure of the project worth. So, you know, if they are the successive phases, so first we can implement the small project, then we can go for the larger project or second phase of the project. And that's why the, you know, the net present worth is the preferred criteria to analyze in such a situation to measure the project benefit and cost. But you know, the we can also use the internal rate of return after having some manipulation in the techniques of calculating this internal rate of return. Even we can use the net benefit investment ratio basically to take the mutually exclusive project, but in this condition basically we need to have ratio of all the projects which we know in advance, so but that is not practically feasible, so it is almost impractical to calculate the net benefit investment ratio. So, you know, we can use the net present worth, and you know, that is the preferred criterion, and we can also use the internal rate of return, but we need to have some alteration in the calculation. So if you want to use this internal rate of return criteria, the cash flow of the, you know, the smaller alternatives is subtracted year by year from the cash flow of the larger alternative too. If there is, you know, two projects are there, one is the small size, another is the large size. So in order to calculate, or in order to use the internal rate of return, basically what we have to do, the cash flow of the smaller alternative should be subtracted from the cash flow of the larger alternative. Then this stream of difference between the, you know, the smaller larger project minus the smaller project is then discounted to determine the internal rate of return of the stream. This method, basically this internal rate of return, gives the financial or economic rate of return to the additional resources necessary to implement the larger alternative as opposed to the smaller one. If the return is above the cutoff rate, the larger alternative is selected. If the return is below, the smaller project is selected. And there are, you know, different examples are there, and there are the different conditions are there where mutually exclusive alternative options arises before the analysis. First is the entirely, you know, different alternative projects that are mutually exclusive. Example is the choice between a small irrigation project that preempt a site and a larger one using this same site. The another example of such mutually exclusive alternative is the scale of projects as a variation of mutually exclusive alternative. Viewing a large project as a mutually exclusive alternative to a small version of the same project. So actually we have the projects, so of two projects, one is the small size, another is the large size, and we can use only one. There is a options available either to select the small project or to select the large project. Then another mutually exclusive alternative is the timing, whether it would be better to begin a project right now or whether we should go for implementation of project on some later date. So in fact, basically postponing a project is a mutually exclusive alternative to undertake it immediately. So whether we should go immediate or whether we will go in some future date. The another option of, example of the mutually exclusive alternative is the choice of alternative technologies. Here, selection of one technology rule out the use of the other technology. So, we can go or we can select only one technology in the projects. And then the another instances of the mutually exclusive alternative is the additional purpose in a multi-purpose project. Like if we have the river basin of project to control flood and generate hydropower, and there is a similar another project which include one additional purpose, that is we can say irrigation purpose. So in such a case, a mutually exclusive alternative to same project without the irrigation project. So here in the first project, river basin project, which have two objective and control flood and also to generate hydropower, but there is another project which have one additional purpose, that is the irrigation purpose. So here there is a two exclusive, we can implement only one project. So here we have to take the decision based on our selection criteria. Then we have entirely different projects, like the mutually exclusive alternative project of entirely different natures. We have one project, we have the small project, but that is give high yield. Then another project we have is the large project, but that is a low yielding project. So here they are the entirely different project, and we have to select only one project. So at a given location, we may have a choice, either constructing a small irrigation project that is limited to the best land, or we use rather in such condition a simple equipment. And then we have another option of building a considerably large project that involve a more extensive areas, and that is more costly project, and that include the complicated engineering work. So there are the different options comes with entirely different projects. If the if the small scheme is built, it preempt the site so that the larger project cannot be built. If you implement a small project, there is no site available for the larger project. In that condition, how to choose among this mutually exclusive alternative of this nature? So here we can select the project using the this net present worth techniques, discounting techniques, and the project having the larger net present worth, we can choose we are using this discounting techniques by using the suitable opportunity cost of the capital as a discounting rate. And there are different options are there, like we have understood the there are exclusive projects, entirely exclusive projects which have different timings. Like we can say as a special case, we have the choice whether to begin a project immediately or we can postpone it. So from analytical point of view, the same project begin today or at same future time may consider as a two in different mutually exclusive projects. The project which are in the view of the same project, we can implement today or we can implement that project in some later date. So we should treat these two project separate mutually exclusive projects, and then we can select the project based project using this net present worth technique. And when we have the option to select the between the technologies, if there is a, you know, there are technological alternatives available and which give the same results, when we design a project, choice of one technology precludes the use of the another technology. We can choose only one technology. In that condition, the criteria will be that project or that technology we should use which have the lower present worth of the cost, because you know the both the technologies giving the same returns, same benefits. So we have to select the one technology which is available at the lower cost. So you know, but if they are having different time profile, you know one technology give return for 5 years, another technology give for return for 10 years, or one technology, you know, that can be implemented within 1 year, or another technology can be implemented in 2 years. So if they have that different time profiles, then choosing of alternative depend on the opportunity cost of the capital. And in case of additional purpose or multi-purpose project, the problem of mutually exclusive alternative arises in multiple purpose projects. And a project design that include one group of purpose is a mutually exclusive alternative to the another project design that include a different group of purpose. And like we have the in rural development project or river basin development projects, so there may be different, you know, purposes. Are there some additional purposes can be added up with such type of projects? So while selecting the one project, we have to give thorough consideration on different objectives or purpose of the project. And now we'll move to the different situations or different considerations while using the, you know, the project analysis, you know. And while conducting this project analysis, and we have to give a consideration on the contingency allowances, and the project which have, you know, the considerable elements of construction in the earlier years, you know, the engineer often give some contingency allowances in the project budget. You know, there are two types of contingency allowances. One is the physical contingency, another is the contingency allowances to reflect the relative price changes, you know, in the cost of the project. So basically, this contingency, they are the real cost in both financial and economic analysis. And you know, we should include this contingency, particularly the physical contingency, into the project account even when in the analyst is working on the constant prices. He is calculating the cost and benefit on the constant prices, even then we need to give this physical contingency in the project account. And then replacement cost is another important aspect while analyzing the projects cost and benefit. And many agriculture projects, basically they require investment that have different lifetime. You know, example here is the pump irrigation scheme. You know, in case of setting or establishing this pump irrigation in a farm, the earthwork or the pump platform may be lasted for 25 years to, you know, 50 years, but the pump themselves may have a life of only 7 to 15 years. So in such condition, in the analysis, we have to make the allowances for the replacement of the pump during the life of the project. So if the project life is of, you know 50 years, and the project life is of, you know, only the pump life is 10 years, so 5 times in the project life we have to change the pump set. So that's why we have to make the proper provision about this cost of the pump. So this cost of pump, you know, changing the pump set after 10 years, that is called as a replacement cost. Then residual value is another important concept which we always use in the project analysis. Basically, at the end of the project, there may be some residual or terminal value of the assets which we have created in the project. So the capital asset will not have been all used in a course of the project period, you know, and there is always, you know, some residual assets. It's, you know, like example is, you know, we have prepared a farm plan of 4 or 5 years, and the pump set is having the life for 10 years. So in the 5 years, we cannot use whole value of the pump set because its life is 10 years. So you know, there is some residual value is there in the pump set. So that residual value of the pump set we have to include in the project analysis. So you know, we have to treat the residual value of the any capital item, say dam or you know, stand of tree, as a project benefit during the last year of the last year of the analysis period. Then domestic resource cost is another important consideration, and you know, in the countries where there are balance of payment problems are there, and where you know there is a import substitution or export promotion is an important objective, you know, of projects or any development activity or in any entrepreneurial activities, and where it is useful to estimate the cost in the domestic currency required to earn a unit of foreign exchange through a proposed project. So you know, the example is, you know, when we have the, you know, the objective to reduce the import from the other country, and you know, we are producing to fulfill the requirement of our domestic demand, so we are saving some, you know, the foreign exchange, and in order to saving some that foreign exchange, you know, we are incurring some cost of production. So we have to compare this cost of production, domestic production, with the saving we are making out of the import. So that is very important consideration, and it's very useful. Like, you know, example here in preparing an oil palm project in which export and or avoidance of vegetable oil import is an important objective. And another example is, you know, in the evaluating a, you know, fertilizer plant intended to reduce or avoid future increase in the import. So if we are, you know, establishing you know, setting up a new fertilizer plant with have intention to reduce the fertilizer import, so it's in such condition we need to give a proper consideration on the domestic resource concept in a project analysis. No, so in that condition, basically, you know, when we have the project analysis, it is not enough to just earn or save the foreign exchange. Actually, we need to analyze the cost of saving the foreign exchange. So how much cost we are incurring in a project to save the foreign exchange, this is important consideration in the project analysis. Basically, it is, this judgment must be made about whether the cost is too high, you know. So if you are suppose we are, you know, saving 100 unit of the dollar by, you know, reducing the import, so to save this 100 dollar, we are incorporating some cost in the project. So we have to compare this, you know, to save the $100 from the import, if you are increasing the cost of $150 in the domestic production system, so there is no need to incorporate this $150 money in the domestic production to save the $100 import from the foreign country. So it is very important consideration. So actually, this domestic resource cost basically express the cost of earning or saving a unit of the foreign exchange as a domestic resource cost, and then we made a comparison with the official exchange rate, and then various pseudo prices for foreign exchange, and such a comparison is one of the basis for evaluating the project, which involves the some, you know, the foreign exchange or foreign trade, which, you know, which have the project objective to save the foreign exchange. And now we can sum up the session that there are situation of mutually exclusive projects in the, you know, like if there are just these situations of mutually exclusive projects are there, we can undertake only one project, and you know, for selection among them, we use the discounting technique, that is the net present worth or we can use also the internal rate of return with some modification. We need to have to analysis to give the proper results, and there are different, entirely different projects are there, which are like, you know, based on the skill of the projects or based on the time of implementation, based on the, you know, additional purposes added to the project objective, or based on the selection of the technologies. And, you know, we need to have proper analysis while selecting the, you know, the best project. And there are some issues which need to be given proper considerations, like the replacement cost, the residual value concept, the domestic resource cost. So all these are very important considerations we need to give in the project analysis for proper selection of the best project. With this, I thank you.